Parker from the National Weather Service office in Phoenix, a meteorologist here at Heil with a forecast update. We're going to focus mainly on the impacts of Hurricane K across the southwestern part of the country. This will be a weakening tropical storm, bringing a lot of moisture northward along the Baja coastline and through the Gulf of California. And that's why we are increasingly concerned about the potential for heavy rain and perhaps some localized flooding. At this point on satellite imagery, this is around 7 o'clock on the 7th here this Wednesday night. You can see the hurricane spinning just off to the west of Cabo San Lucas. It's going to parallel the west coast there of the Baja, moving north-northwest in time. And here is the latest track for this hurricane, bringing it very close to the coastline over the next 24 to 36 hours. You can see across parts of the Baja coast, central Baja coast, we do have a hurricane warning in effect. As it moves northward across the cooler shelf waters, they're just offshore of the northern Baja and southwestern coast of California, we do expect a weakening trend. This will become a tropical storm and then essentially a non-tropical or extra-tropical cyclone in time. But again, as it moves closer to us, it's going to draw a lot of moisture northward, especially from Friday into Saturday. And another way to look at this is an animation of all the forecast models put together and averaged out, showing the path of that surface low pressure system, and those shaded colors indicating where some of that heavier rain is going to reside. As we let this loop one more time, you can see this is more toward Thursday and then into Friday and early Saturday, that heavier rain comes up the Gulf of California, and some of it even makes its way into southwest Arizona and southeast California. So what are we talking about? How much rain are we expecting? Pick out your hometown or nearest city there. Notice in Phoenix, the amounts are fairly light, but as you push west toward the Colorado River into southeast California, those rain amounts increase. The current forecast range, 1 to 1.5, locally 2 inches, Yuma, El Centro, and over toward Joshua Tree National Park. And it's in those darker green shaded areas on the map where a flood watch has been issued from Friday afternoon through Saturday evening. That is the biggest threat. We could see some storms with this system, but the main concern is going to be repeated rounds of rain over the same areas causing flash flooding. In terms of the risk for flash flooding, the highest chance of that occurring is going to be nearby areas like Yuma and El Centro, where around a 40% risk is run for flash flooding within 25 miles of those locations sometime Friday into Friday night and early Saturday morning. So again, that is the primary target time frame for potential flood hazard impacts along that IA corridor especially. Here in Phoenix, it's going to be an isolated threat of rain, and that for that reason, with the chances being lower for rainfall, that's good news in terms of a lower flash flood risk. We could all use the rain, but we don't want it to come in too quick of an amount of time to cause that flooding concern. Another way to look at this is the excessive rainfall potential outlook from the Weather Prediction Center. In that shade of yellow, that is the slight risk or around a 15% chance of seeing flash flooding. That's roughly from Gila Bend westward to near Parker and then points west into Riverside County. And then Yuma, El Centro up toward, let's say, Salton City, you're in that red shaded area. That is around a 40% risk of seeing flash flooding within 25 miles of a point. And by the way, if you're traveling farther west into southeast California, and then farther towards San Diego County and the San Diego Mountains, with the terrain influencing the precipitation potential, it's those locations that actually have the highest rainfall potential with this system. So here is the bottom line. K is going to hug the coastline of Baja, approaching parts of California, but staying just offshore over the next 3 to 4 days. The greatest impacts will be closest to that system. So southeast California, southwest Arizona, in our forecast area, we'll see the highest risk of heavy rain and potentially some flooding. Wind gusts could also be on the order of 25 to 40 miles per hour as this system makes its closest approach, especially in Yuma and El Centro, places like that, on Friday and Friday evening. One good thing to note, this is going to bring a lot of cloud cover into the area, and temperatures will fall below normal, in fact, below 100 degrees, even here in Phoenix, with highs in the mid-90s on Friday and Saturday. Once again, a flood watch in effect for southeast California, southwest Arizona. with the potential for heavy rainfall over 1 inch in those areas. We'll keep you posted and have more updates right here in our social media channels as we get more information over the next 24 hours. Have a great night.